what we do over here. Let's get into it. Who is Haitian Jack?
All bets are off. I've been running from immigration. This immigration case was 1990, 1991. I end up staying out of trouble from 1990 to 2004, 14-year run. In the process of running, I get caught in 04 for the shooting on Melrose, attempted murder case. The police, they hit me with that charge. But I knew I could beat it because I had friends in high places. How can you classify me as a bad guy when I'm chasing the same person that the government is chasing? Right? You know what I'm saying? I'm chasing drug dealers, killers, you know what I'm saying? And I'm trying to cripple them by taking their wealth from them. Because that's how you cripple a nigga, through the pockets. You see what I'm saying? So what I ain't understand is this. Every nigga I ever shot was a bad nigga. I shot niggas that shot pregnant women. So I thought I was going to get a reward for shooting that nigga. You understand what I'm saying to you? And then I'm robbing drug dealers who's selling drugs to your children. So how am I a bad nigga? Right. You know what I'm saying? When the feds caught me and said they know what I do, I was worried about something else. They said, yeah, we heard you rob drug dealers. I was like, I was in a state of shock, my nigga. I said, you were looking for me because I was robbing drug dealers? You care about these niggas? You know what I'm saying? So it was like, no, but when you put a gun in their face, I said, who told you that? He wasn't there. You know? And they started laughing and said, Jack, you know, you put a gun in their face and that's when it becomes our business. I said, listen, homie, it ain't that serious, playboy. You know, if these niggas were selling drugs to your kids, you'd be more than happy that I robbed them. You know what I'm saying? If you're on the wrong side of the law, then you got a lot to worry about. You know? It's like this, man. When you're in a drug game, there's two people that's going to come for you, my nigga. It's the feds and me. And niggas like me. We're coming. Both of us. That's a guarantee we're coming, bro. Right. What you would like to happen is I come first. Because, see, if I rob you for all your drugs, and then the next day the feds kick your door in, at least you're not going to go to prison. You understand? So it might be a good thing that I got you. I might have saved you from 100 years. Pac was all good when I was doing good things to him. Until we caught that punk-ass case that was easily could have been beaten by both of us.
The singer was arrested Thursday night after a woman claimed that he and three other men overpowered her in a hotel suite.
He let his attorneys turn him against me. And that's the part that I'll never forgive him for, because I'm going to ride or die with you, homie. I expect you to do the same. See, that's what I call a fair weather friend. Everything's good when everything's good, you know? But as soon as we catch a punk-ass case, right, you start telling me, oh, I can't talk to you, my attorney. I'm like, what? You ain't who you say you are, my nigga. You ain't no gangster. No gangster's attorney can tell him not to talk to his man. He'd be like, listen, bro, just do your job as an attorney. That's my man, okay? And then Pac and Madonna started hanging out. The problem with Pac and Madonna, he liked it her, and she realized that he wasn't who he said he was. Pac wasn't no gangster. And they told her, I was that dude. Something about, well, you know, Jack's with Madonna, and Madonna don't seem to be too into you anymore. And he was like, well, girl, right? Deal with her, bruh. Don't bring no man into this, man. I'm a man, my man. Don't play no games with me, playboy. Because I'm going to take you there.